A snowflake is made of water molecules, billions of them. How can a single ingredient spontaneously create these intricate symmetrical designs? How do snowflakes self-organize? To find out, let's build a six-sided starlet. Level 1. Molecules. A frozen water molecule contains three atoms, one oxygen atom and two hydrogen atoms, sticking off at a 104.5 degree angle. The oxygen atom exerts a greater pull on the electrons in H2O, drawing them close and making the oxygen slightly negative, and the hydrogens slightly positive. This polarity of the molecule determines much about the snowflake's growth. Level 2, the lattice. In H2O, just like with magnets, like charges repel and opposite charges attract. So when water molecules bond onto a growing snowflake, it's always between the negative oxygen of one and the positive hydrogen of the other. The hexagonal symmetry begins here, at the molecular level, 10 million times smaller than the final snowflake. As floating water molecules attach, more rings form and the crystal extends into what's called a lattice. A lattice repeats its one basic molecular unit in three dimensions, and it actually classifies ice as a mineral. Level 3, faceting. How does a snowflake become six-sided? This simplified diagram illustrates how self-organization works through a process called faceting. Water molecules diffusing through a cloud collide with a growing ice lattice on all sides. Some bounce off, others attach, many will evaporate. The edge of an ice lattice is a very dynamic place. Hitting the lattice at an uneven spot, a water molecule is held strongly by several points of attachment. Smooth edges offer fewer points of attachment, so the bumpier parts of the lattice attract more molecules and let fewer slip away. Thus, the rough edges grow faster. When they fill in and become smooth, their growth naturally slows. Soon, the lattice grows into a hexagonal prism. Once a prism has taken shape, a second dynamic comes into play: branching. The corner of an ice prism sticks out farther into the air than the sides, causing diffusing water molecules to hit it sooner. At first, it's only by the tiniest bit, but with every molecule that bonds, the corner grows larger, causing more and more molecules to attach. This snowballs into a positive feedback loop, and branches grow outward from all six corners. You won! Snowflake achieved! The snowflake is an example of how complexity can emerge out of the simple interactions between identical molecules. For humans to produce anything as involved, we would typically organize ourselves into a hierarchy, following instructions passed down from above. But no one's in charge of building a snowflake. Every six-sided starlet is a triumph of non-engineering. This is Wonder Science TV. Thanks for watching and keep wondering.